Welcome! In this video series, we are going to explain what smart contracts and DApps are. A contract is an agreement between multiple parties, enforced by law. A smart contract is a program that facilitates secure transactions without third parties. Traditional contracts are enforced by law, while smart contracts are enforced by code. This makes it a self-executing contract. Because there is no intermediary, smart contracts aim to provide more security to be faster and less expensive than traditional contracts. Instead of trusting the law, you trust computer code. The term smart contract was first coined in 1994 by Nick Szabo, easily one of the most important figures in the crypto space. Nick Szabo uses the vending machine as an example of a primitive ancestor of smart contracts. Instead of going to a shop to buy candy from a clerk, you can make automatic transactions with the vendor through a machine, without an intermediary. If you insert a coin, the machine goes on. You can choose a product by clicking a button and the machine dispenses it. Smart contract platforms store the latest state of a smart contract. Let's see how a state transition works by using the vending machine as an example. Imagine a very simple vending machine, where you can just buy one item for $1 at a time, no change. This machine would just have two states, off and on. There are two inputs that could affect its state, inserting a coin and pushing a button. Putting in a coin in the off state shifts the state from off to on. If somebody gives a push input in the on state, the customer would receive its candy and the state would switch back to off. If this vending machine was using smart contracts, every time a state transition is made, it would have to be updated on the entire network and a fee would be charged. Okay, now let's look at a simpler, more tangible example of a smart contract. Two strangers, Alice and Bob, want to make a bet if it will snow or not on December 24th, 2018. Alice says it will snow, Bob says it won't. They don't trust each other, but they also don't want to make a physical contract and hire an expensive lawyer. So they both put money into a smart contract. This contract sets the betting conditions and will release the funds to the winner. On December 25th, the smart contract talks to an outside API and checks if it snowed on December 24th. If it did, the contract sent the money to Alice's address, and if not, it sends it to Bob's. So this is how a smart contract could settle a simple bet without an intermediary. Smart contracts are essentially computer programs that are executed on a blockchain-based distributed computing platform. In the next video, we will talk more about these platforms.